Ich freue mich sehr, einen wirklichen EU-Experten auf dieser Bühne begrüßen zu dürfen.
I'm glad to welcome Dustin Hoffmann, a real expert in EU affairs. This is Dustin Hoffmann. He's going to tell us a little bit about the EU and its institutions. I think it is amazing that since 71 years we have peace for more than 300 million people in Europe.
Trotzdem entsteht eine unglaubliche Komplexität.
Nevertheless, there is a bunch of complex systems working together between these 28 countries in one union, and this has benefits and also negative aspects, of course. Dustin is going to explain us a lot about this, but nevertheless, this is one union and we have peace.
Hallo. Ja, sehr gut.
Hi.
Hallo.
Perfect.
Vielen Dank für die Einführung. Ich bin Dustin Hoffmann.
Thank you for the introduction. I'm Dustin Hoffmann. I am the head of office of the office of Martin Sonneborn, a German MEP, a member of the European Parliament. I'm I have a legal training and I have landed in Brussels quite a while ago. I am very glad that I can tell you a little bit about the European institutions now, especially because there will be elections next year. You might have heard a lot of things about this before already. It seems like this is going to be the deal breaker for Europe, this election. So I want to give you some broader picture about the institutions, and I am especially glad to be here to be able to talk to you because of the police laws that I heard about yesterday, and I noticed that a lot of you here in the audience have the same the same positions towards this politician, Herbert Reul, and I was the only person watching this video back in the days when he was a member of the European Parliament and had held an address about the State of the Union. When he became the governor of the state of North Rhine-Westphalia, many people were surprised, but I was not. So, anyways, let's move on to the content. This will be a broad overview because I expect that you know nothing. So some of you might be a bit bored and it might not be interesting to you, but for many of you it will be interesting because I will go in, give you a broader picture of all of the institutions that are part of the system of lawmaking, especially the European Parliament, and I will explain like how laws are made in the European Union. Afterwards, I will tell you like what was the message of this talk in the end. I want you to have a couple of terms in your head that you understand, because once the media will start talking about the European elections next year, it will be important that you know some of the words and their meaning. For example, there is one topic like copyright reform, which is part of the trilogue, and you should understand what trilogue means, for example, after this talk. So let's start with the institutions of the European Union. As part of the Treaty of the European Union, there are a bunch of organized institutions. There's the Parliament, the Council, and the European Parliament, the European Council, and the Council of the European Union, not to be confused with the European Council. And there you see the European Commission, the European Court of Justice, the European Central Bank, and the European
Ich will mich allerdings auf die oberen vier konzentrieren, ganz kurz zu den unteren.
I want to focus to the top four. The Central Court of Justice in Luxembourg, the Central Bank just for the stability of the European Union, the Court of Justice also in Luxembourg, and look, it takes care that everything's doing well.
Ich sollen die ersten vier sein.
So let's take a closer look on the top four and a special focus on those three, because those three are the ones that are responsible for European legislation procedure.
Es gibt neben den Organen noch allerhand Agenturen.
Besides of those institutions, there are also a lot of other institutions. Just have a look at it to see that there are like plenty.
Das sind einige, die ihr auch kennt. Die nehmen
some of those
Aufgaben
are known. They do some special. They have special like Frontex, the European Policy, Europol. Those institutions are spread all around Europe, so that everyone can take share of the European Union. Those who are responsible for the legislative procedure, it's the European Parliament, the European Council, and the European Commission.
Und die Aufteilung der dreien ist so, dass die Europäische Kommission schlägt die Gesetze vor
Commission
und das Europäische Parlament und der Rat der Europäischen Union
makes the proposals of the legislation and then the Council and the European Parliament they decide on each other how to develop those legislative procedures.
Findet zum größten Teil
most of the work is done in the nice city of Brussels. I take you on a journey to the capital of Belgium.
Belgien, Brüssel, bekannt
Belgium, Brussels, known for many things. Schokolade, for example, chocolate, Bier, waffles, beer.
Beer.
There's a very good beer culture in Belgium and the European Union. Inofficial, the capital of the European Union.
Where
most of the institutions are located.
I
don't know who's been in Brussels before, but everything is very close to each other. This is the European Council. Next to it, there's
the rooms.
Just across, it's the building of the European Commission, where the president of the European Commission is situated.
Dieses Viertel, in dem sich das hier befindet, heißt nicht nur ohne grundeuropäisches Quartier,
not only known to
sondern
be the European quarter,
alle Gebäude, die hier sind,
but
haben
all
eigentlich
the
was mit dem zu tun. Bei der Europäischen Kommission arbeiten über 30.000 Leute. Und alle Gebäude, die nicht zur Kommission gehören, da,
all buildings that don't belong to the commissions are used by
also
agencies, institutions.
EU am Wochenende,
everything is European Union, and in the weekend there's nothing going on.
Ein bisschen gekünstelt, ist auch bestimmt mal.
So a little bit artificial.
Wir haben es wirklich sehr, sehr breit gemacht.
But we just spread around there. But if you walk like 10 minutes by foot, you reach the European Parliament, the European representation of the citizens.
Aber das ist genauso wie bei der Kommission, das beschränkt sich nicht darauf.
It's like the European Commission, it's not restricted to the building, there are also the rooms for trainings.
Und für alle, die, wenn ihr irgendwann mal nach Brüssel
fahrt,
kann ich euch empfehlen,
and like all of you come to Brussels, go there on a Thursday night, because the working weeks of the European Parliament, the MEPs, members of European Parliament, they don't live in Brussels, but they just come there and stay until Thursday, they leave during the day. That is why in there's this nice tradition in Brussels on this place, Platz Luxembourg. All the restaurants, they put some beer stands outside and they're just like bunch of young people, thousands. They meet each week. It's very nice to look at. If you're close by, never forget to join.
So, fange ich mit der Europäischen Kommission an.
So, let's start with the European Commission. It's the executive of the European Union. There's like the quasi government, but not the real government.
Die Europäische Kommission wird einmal am Anfang vom Parlament bestätigt und wird dann nicht mehr.
In the beginning of the legislation procedure, the European Parliament confirms the European Commission.
Das spielt eine ganz große Rolle, wenn ich euch später erkläre, wie sich die Abstimmungsdynamik im EP verhält.
This is a very important role to understand the voting procedure in the European Parliament. I'll come back to that later. What's very important is that the Commission has the only right for an initiative to start a legislative procedure. In Germany, the parliament can put in some legislative procedure, but in Brussels they cannot do it. That's why some people laugh at the European Parliament. But we're not that far in Brussels. It's also known as the keeper of the contracts.
Die Europäische Union
so
ausmachen, dass irgendein Staat das
they
nicht,
check if some
einhält,
member states do not are not
Staat,
confirmed with
so
the
nicht,
with the law
sag mal, warum das so machst,
then the commission
Staat, warum das so macht,
will take a look
Kommission,
and
das reicht uns aber nicht, ändert das mal und Ja, das ist die Might Rolle initiate der Kommission. Die Kommission wird geleitet against the member state.
It's led through the president of the European Commission. That's this guy, Jean-Claude Juncker.
Aus unterschiedlichen Sachen, vielleicht einerseits als Kommissionspräsident, andererseits wahrscheinlich auch, weil er im Rahmen der LuxLeaks-Affäre als ehemaliger luxemburgischer Ministerpräsident im Kontext aufgetaucht ist, dass er Steuerdeals mit großen Unternehmen gemacht hat. Aber er ist auch bekannt für sein Verhalten. Ich habe einen kurzen Clip mitgebracht von Jean-Claude Juncker bei der Begrüßung des letzten Brexit-Ratsgipfels. Vielleicht kennen manche das schon.
Might be known to some of you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So machen wir das in Brüssel?
That's how we do in Brussels.
Also,
you see,
Videos von ihm.
There are like a lot of funny videos of him.
Bei denen er den Staats- und Regierungschefs zur Begrüßung welche Backpfeifen verpasst.
There are some videos where he gives a kick to the other head of state. There's one video where he didn't realize the microphone was on when Viktor Orban was approaching in, and he said, oh, there's a dictator coming.
Es gibt unterschiedliche Gerüchte.
There are different rumors why he is.
Will ja jetzt auch, aber hier jetzt keiner vor so großem Auditorium.
But in this with this huge audience, I don't want to spread any rumors. It's what it makes them nice person.
The
European Commission isn't only led by the president, but it's constituted of like commissioners from every member state. So every member state can send a commissioner to the European Commission. So the European Council makes a proposal of for the president of the European Commission. The European Parliament can say yes or no, but it should reflect the opinion of the voters. Then the president will make a proposal with the commissioners from each member state. They will visit the parliament, and in some hearings they have to defend the questions of the European Parliament. So the parliament has to drill them and ask questions, and they will then confirm each commissioner. I presented to you Jean-Claude Juncker, but there are some that you should know, like Franz Timmermans, it's the vice president, or the responsible for foreign affairs and security policy. Günther Oettinger, known as well, it's the German commissioner. He's responsible for budget and human resources, but as we all know, he started as the digital commissioner. His heritage, we have to deal with his heritage today. The restriction Article 11 for press and communication.
Einer der Kommissare mit den meisten Lobbytreffen.
It's one of the commissioners with most of lobbyist meetings.
He
said, yes, nobody can tell me I'm not working.
Also er ist immer wieder in den Schlagzeilen, weil er irgendwelche Affären an der Backe hatte, wie das irgendwie zu Viktor Orban im Privatjet fliegt von unserem
Or one in his private jet. And in a hearing afterwards, he said,
yes,
you know, I'm hiding behind newspapers. In case someone speaks to me, it might be an intransparent lobbying meeting.
Those are his problems. But, you know, in politics, heute bringen die Leute ihre Privatjets ja schon mit.
Some people just bring their own jets. So.
Vielleicht auch eine Frau, die jetzt
another woman that you should know.
Wettbewerbskommissarin,
it's our competition commissioner.
Ist dann, dass sie es geschafft hat, wenn Wettbewerbsfragen, Wettbewerbs- und Kartellfragen allen Unternehmen in der Welt das Schrecken zu lernen. Also die,
so, yeah, she did the good job of teaching all the companies that they should be afraid of European competition law. They're all like shrinking in their seats when they have to listen, when they hear about the German competition law.
Ich habe das eben schon mal angedeutet, die unterschiedlichen Räte.
There's also a bunch of different councils. So there's the Council of the European Union, the European Council, and the Europe the European Council and the Council of the Council of Europe. Like that. So the first one, the Council of the European Union, is one of the co-legislators. So there's all of the specific ministers from the member states working on a specific issue. Then there's the European Council, which is when all of the heads of state get together. That's what you know from the TV, for example. I live in that area where they meet, so like whenever that happens, I can't sleep because there's helicopters in the air all of the time. So they do not work on legislation per se, but they give like the guidelines. They make the big decisions, basically. And then there's also the Council of Europe, which is a totally different organization. It's a European international organization with 47 member states, including Russia and other states in Eastern Europe. They work on human rights, where different member states meet. For example, the Charter of the European Charter of Human Rights is guarded by the Council of Europe. If you were, for example, in Tiflis before, in Tbilisi, the capital of Georgia, there's also European flags hanging around everywhere, but that's because the Council of Europe also has the same flag as the European Union. So that's also all quite confusing. Here you can see Donald Tusk. He's the president of the European Council. He's Polish, and he's coordinating together with his general secretary all of the meetings of the heads of state. And usually there used to be a rotation every half year, but now there's like one head of the council. Here there's the new building that they have there where they meet. It's beautiful. I like to show it for that. So back there there's this egg-shaped thing. They have the facade made out of restored windows, recycled windows from all over Europe. Beautiful, right? So let's move over to the other council, the more important one. It's the Council of the European Union, and that's part of the legislative process, so that's where all of the ministers come together. They decide about the budget of the European Union. They have an important role in the treaties that the European Union takes part in for the member states, and also for economic policies and common agriculture policy and defense. It is not elected. It's kind of democratically legitimate because the people that take decisions there are sent from the member states, and those member states have elected governments, but like it's a lot longer chain of like responsibility compared to the European Parliament. There's quite a disbalance, actually. So in this council, the presidency changes between different countries. So in the past, for example, now it has been Austria for the past half year, and next year it's going to be Romania for the next half year. And they look at, well, what's on our to-do list, what's on the agenda for legislation that we want to pass in the European Union. The quality of these presidencies is very dependent on those countries. Some of the smaller countries feel like this is quite some pride in like taking over this council role, presidency role, and they invest a lot of energy and time. Well, if Germany does that, then just like gets mentioned in the news, I guess. So here we can take a look at the next couple of years. Next up, it's going to be Romania. The expectations are not that high after all, but I mean, like with Austria, it was quite bad as well. Well, it's bad times.
Der Rat der EU
So the Council of the European Union,
sich in Gremien, muss man verstehen, it
has a bunch of sub-councils. They are kind of like committees in a parliament.
So the
one for
the
General Affairs Council is the one that is coordinating all of
the things that
it does everything that doesn't really fit into all of the other fields. For example, also constitutional things. It kind of works like in a parliament, just that it's ministers from the member states that come together.
One of the hardest things about this
is that there is a different way of finding majorities in the council than in parliaments. You don't have to find 50% of the people there, but rather for easy things, for less important things, it's enough to find a normal majority, so 15 out of 28 member states. But for some, for the more important things, you need a qualified majority, which is at least 55% of the member states that represent at least 65% of the population of the European Union have to agree. So there is a way for only 4 member states that represent 35% of the population to have a veto against everything. And as the council is part of the co-legislation process with the commission and the parliament and has to agree to everything, it's really, really hard to pass any laws in the European Union without the support of the member states. With this complicated system, the negotiations between the co-legislators get even more complicated.
For instance, if there's a new membership of the European Union, they have to be like with all the votes. So this makes everything very difficult. As all member states have very different interests in some areas.
Das Parlament.
The European Parliament. It's located in Strasbourg.
Now
you might be surprised because at the beginning I showed you what it looks like in Brussels. So it's also located in Brussels and in Luxembourg.
Das hat historische Gründe.
This
in den Verträgen
due
steht
to historic
nicht,
reasons,
dass das Parlament 12-mal im Jahr
as
in Straßburg tagt.
The European Parliament is 12 times a year in Strasbourg.
Das hat die Konsequenz, dass der ganze Trost, Brüssel ist der Arbeitssitz.
The Brussels is the area of work, so the whole institution moves to Strasbourg twice a year. So we have like whole trains, buses, some people take the plane, some members of parliament come by car from the member states. The hotels raise their prices, and from Monday to Thursday there are all the sessions, and then everybody goes back. The problem is that the European Parliament cannot decide on where it wants to hold the meetings. It's within the constitution that they have to be in Strasbourg 12 times a year. To change this constitution, we need the votes of all member states. And there's one member state that's not at all interested in changing this constitution.
Frankreich.
France.
Deswegen ist es vollkommen egal, das Parlament hat in mehreren Beschlüssen gesagt,
this
hey, wir wollen
why
das
the
nicht.
European Parliament, they did in a lot of meetings, they decided they don't want to do this anymore. It costs like between 120 and 180 millions a year.
Aber Straßburg ist eine schöne Stadt.
But Strasbourg, it's a nice city. It was
Stadt.
In the media a few weeks ago, the oldest Christmas markets of Europe.
Aber wir haben ja noch ein paar andere Institutionen, die habe ich
ja vorgestellt. But we also have some other institutions. This is the building of the European
Hier drüben ist der Europäische Gerichtshof für Menschenrechte.
European Court of Justice.
Die kümmern sich quasi um die Auslegung von der Menschenrechtskonvention.
And this is European
also ganz nah beieinander,
Human Rights Convention. And you know the Court of Justice, they take the
so. Habe ich schon gesagt, einzig direkt gewähltes
yes,
Organ der EU,
the only origin of
die einzig
the
direkt gewählte
elected.
Supranationale
it's Institution the only weltweit, of the world. It's co-constitutional.
Der Co-Gesetzgeber 751
There's
Abgeordnete.
751 members of parliament, 750 plus the dran. President of the European Parliament.
I say, eine wichtige Sache beim Europaparlamentarismus, Sitzverteilung erfolgt
You have to know that it's degressive proportional. This means that every member state had at least 6 seats and a maximum of 96 seats.
Dem Maximum, das
There's
ist
one
Deutschland.
State with the maximum, that's Germany. There are a lot of small states like Malta and Cyprus that only have 6 members of parliaments.
Nicht direkt, also nicht direkt demokratisch,
That's
weil eigentlich sozusagen jeder Bürger sollte
because every citizen like the vote of every citizen should represent the same.
Wenn man das wirklich nach
But
der
if we really would spread it according to the member state size, then the parliament should be very, very large, or
die kleinen Länder hätten eigentlich
small countries should have like no representatives at all.
Das, so ist man zum Schluss gekommen, dass Deutschland
That's why they also concluded that there should be a disproportional
Bei der nächsten Wahl wird das Parlament ein bisschen kleiner.
In the next election, the size of the parliament should be reduced because we expect that in March one member state will leave our union.
Das Parlament hat sich,
so that means only
775
members of parliament.
All the seats of Britain should be distributed to member states that were
At a disadvantage, not Germany.
Falls wir die EU erweitern,
Some should
und ein paar
be
sollten
left empty in case for further extension of the European Union.
Dazu ist nicht gekommen, aber was
and
das ist,
some should be raised,
erkläre ich euch
but
in
that
Kontext
didn't happen. But I will
der Wahlen
explain later
zum Europäischen Parlament.
In the context
euch
of the
ist ja wahrscheinlich
European
schon
elections.
Aufgefallen, dass ihr,
Every member
ihr in
state
wählt,
is responsible for their own elections.
Die Parteien wählen könnt, die ihr sonst in Deutschland auch wählen könnt.
You
das liegt
can
daran,
elect
the
parties as you know them for all German elections.
Also jeder Staat führt die Wahlen selbst durch. Ihr könnt keine Kandidaten
There are no
aus
transnational candidates, so you cannot vote for candidates from France or from Greece.
Das ist für einen deutschen Europaabgeordneten vielleicht nicht ganz wichtig ist, zu machen, also
A German member of your parliament might not be interested in doing politics for a Greek member of parliament.
Das größte Anliegen für viele Leute im Rahmen der europäischen Integration ist, endlich Transnationalisten zu haben, richtige
So that's the goal of many people who are for transnational European Union to have like transnational candidates.
Merkt euch das Wort, da kommt gleich mal
So the European Union is the rough right framework
doing
through the direct vote.
Grobe Fristen festgelegt.
There are just
some
laws on timing, but there are no real European
was
elections.
Was euch über den Weg laufen wird, sind die Spitzenkandidaten.
Some
das ist eine Sache, die hat sich
candidates.
Das EP ein bisschen erschlichen. Und
And
zwar
that's like
habe ich am Anfang gesagt,
European
dass der Europäische Rat den Kommissionspräsidentschaftskandidaten unter Berücksichtigung des Wahlergebnisses vorschlägt.
Before,
und vor 2014, vor der Wahl,
European
haben sich die Spitzen im Europaparlament zusammengesetzt und haben gesagt, wir sagen denen, dass wir nur einen Kandidaten
parliament.
Wählen werden, der vorher Spitzenkandidat an der Europäischen Partei war,
only take the
um so Einfluss aufzunehmen, wer Kommissionspräsident wird über die europäischen Parteien. Und bei der letzten Wahl waren die Spitzenkandidaten zum Beispiel von der Europäischen Volkspartei war es Jean-Claude
During
Juncker,
the last beginning of the European
SPD
People's Party, there was Juncker, of the SND, there was
Schulz, und dann kam es Wahl,
of the Greens, it was Keller.
Also die EVP hat die Wahl gewonnen.
But then the parliament
wir,
came
and
the EPP party said we only accept Jean-Claude Juncker.
Zum Beispiel Angela Merkel war große Gegnerin
instance,
davon, die wollte das nicht.
Angela Merkel,
und
she was really against it.
And this is why there's still
a rough tension between the institutions because the parliament said we just do it this way. This is like our right, but it's a right they just took on the go.
It was a
smart move of the European parliament.
Aber Spitzenkandidaten komme ich wieder, das würden die ersten Wohner schon gewählt.
So
laufen wir wieder über den Weg. Parlament für 5 Jahre gewählt, anders als der Bundestag.
It's
nächste
elected
Wahl
for 5 years, different to the
Und
German
es wird
parliament.
Keine Sperrklausel geben.
The next elections are in 2000 and there's no restrictive clause in Germany.
Ja. Jetzt habt ihr das Pech, dass Wahlrecht eins meiner Lieblingsthemen ist.
Now
und meine Freunde hassen mich dafür.
You know,
deswegen habe ich gedacht, dass ich schon mal hier bin.
Elective law is one of my favorite topics.
Dann kann ich ein bisschen über die Sperrklausel fürs
So now I can talk a little bit about the blocking clause.
Also bis
so until 2011, there was a 5% blocking clause.
Da gab es eine 5%-Hürde, wie für den Bundestag.
As for the German parliament, for the Bundestag.
Haben Leute dagegen geklagt.
And then some people went to court against this. For us in Germany, it's normal. Nobody is questioning this, even though it's not very democratic. You know, I'm against it.
Das Bundesverfassungsgericht hat sich das damals angeguckt.
But the German Federal Constitutional Court said it's okay if it's necessary to...
Dann haben sie sich angeguckt, wie das Europaparlament arbeitet, und gesagt, Mensch,
to make sure that governments can be formed, but like in the European Parliament, you don't really have to form a government, so like you don't really need it there. So there are already more than 160 parties in this, and there are works together with the groups, and maybe there is no splitter effect because of this. So maybe we don't need it for the European elections. And suddenly it was gone. And that was, there was a bad mood with all of the German parties. Maybe we can introduce a new one, maybe at 3% or something.
And kippen genauso eine 3%. But I mean, yeah, the haben die Experten auch gesagt,
the logic of the court,
was hat der Gesetzgeber gemacht?
Doesn't really care whether it's 3% or 5%, well, whatever. And the reaction of the Austrian, of the German lawmaker was that they introduced a 3% barrier. And well, once again, the constitutional court said no.
This is illegal. Deswegen habe ich ein kurzes Video.
And that made the mood of the parties even worse. And this is one of my favorite statements from politicians in Germany. So the third point is that we have the least amount of members ever. But this is only to a limited degree our fault, because you have to look at it, that the decision makers in the Constitutional Court moved away this barrier of 3%. This is the reason why there's NPD, ÖDP, and a bunch of other funny parties in the European Parliament. And this was a very bad decision of the Constitutional Court, of the highest court in Germany, and we have to deal with that as a lawmaker every day now. I still have the hope that after all, the judges will understand how hard it is now to come up with actual political solutions. So you have to think about it, the European Parliament must be dead now, right? Can't work anymore. So at least Herbert Reul, you see him, he has been talking bullshit even before he was the governor of NRW. But anyways, yeah. Well, it's not our fault. If Europe breaks now, it's the fault of the Constitutional Court.
And
I always thought that the citizens decide who gets into the parliament. But no, not for the CDU.
Könnte man denken, okay,
so anyways, the 3% clause gone. So
akzeptieren wir jetzt.
Well, we might as well assume that they would accept it, and but no, the Frank-Walter Steinmeier, the former foreign minister of Germany, has said that he wants to have such a clause now on the European level.
Hat er gesagt, na gut,
so, well, he said, okay, what can we do now?
And
he thought, maybe we can get this on a European level. And after all, in November 2015, one of the very little things that the European Parliament can do on its own, it made a proposal for a new electoral reform. And the council, that can make a counter-proposal to that. That doesn't have to do anything to do with the proposal by the European Parliament. And the European Parliament had a pretty useful proposal for some elective law, for example, voting with 16 and transnational lists and other important things.
And that seems pretty cool, maybe that you
have to hand in the list of candidates 12 weeks ahead and not 2 weeks ahead like it is in some countries. And then it went to the council, and it has to be decided by the council unanimously. So,
well, that's pretty hard. damals, nachdem es im Parlament durchging, da haben wir Post bekommen. So
after that passed in the Parliament, we got a letter
geschickt, was das Auswärtige Parlament denkt. So ein Dokument aus dem Auswärtigen Amt, was eigentlich
a document from the Foreign Office of Germany.
Aber guck mal, was das Auswärtige Amt gesagt hat, da habe ich mir gedacht, ach, Mensch, toll, demokratisch
aus Europa. The Foreign Office,
was das Auswärtige Amt, unser Kernanliegen ist die von EP vorgeschlagen, Einführung einer verbindlichen Mindestschule für die
The most important thing for us is that the European Parliament has
die letzte Europawahl 2014 darf sich nicht wiederholen. Deutsche Sitz schon bei 0,5%, 7 deutsche Sitz
is supporting a new clause at 3%. So, what happened next is that the council took a long time, we thought it was dead, the law, nothing is happening, and we are a party that is growing and growing, but one of the fears that we share, for example, with the Social Democrats is that we might not make it over the threshold if there were one.
Da dachten wir schon, Mensch, ja, vielleicht gut, beißen wir einen sauren Apfel, kriegen wir transnationale Listen, kriegen wir demokratischere Europawahlen.
When the proposal of the council came back, maybe we thought, well, maybe we get something back. Maybe there will be a clause again at 3%, but in return we get transnational lists and voting with 16 and so on and so forth.
Der leitet im wissenschaftlichen Dienst des Deutschen Bundestages
the scientific service of the German Parlament,
the constitutional service there, said,
well, it would be okay if everything in this law gets dropped except for the clause at 3%.
Keine transnationalen Listen, keine
Geschlechtergerechtigkeit. So what happened to the proposal of the European Parliament? Nothing happens, no e-voting, no voting with 16, no nothing except for this clause, this blocking clause at 3%. So everything that's good went away, everything that's bad is still there. And of course, the parliament agreed. So,
auch insbesondere der SPD-Mann, der das geführt hat, gesagt, super toll, Wahlen werden jetzt viel besser.
Social Democrat, for example, who was in charge of that proposal, said, well, it's kind of good, let's agree with that.
Jeder Mitgliedstaat diese Sache ratifizieren.
And the thing is that every national parliament now has to agree to that.
Wir dachten, das schaffen die eh nicht bis zur nächsten Wahl.
We thought, they're never going to make it until the next.
Bei der CDU haben sie gesagt, machen wir noch im September fertig. Next, also kommt auf jeden Fall, wir wollen das auf jeden Fall durchhaben.
Und dann it came up in Germany.
Und ihr braucht dafür eine doppelte Zweidrittelmehrheit.
The scientific service of the German Parliament came back and told them, well, we don't only need a normal majority, but rather a two-third majority in both chambers of the German Parliament. And they figured out, well, we don't even have a majority like that. Christian Democrats, Social Democrats, we're missing six seats. And they thought, well, the Greens might help us there. And the Greens were, no, we're not going to do that on their party congress. They decided that they're not going to do it.
They think it is
undemocratic, at least, to rush it like that. Even the people who are in favor of that say, well, no, we're not going to do it this quickly. And the end of this whole crime story is that a question has been answered by the responsible minister, Andrea Nahles, and her answer was, no, we're not going to do this, we're not going to introduce this law before the next European elections 2019. So, you know, there's a right to informational freedom, and you can ask for all sorts of things that the government is working on,
like
emails and letters and so on and so forth.
And
there are some quirks with that. You might not be able to request all of the content of all of these documents, but you have the right to ask for just a list of which documents exist. And out of this information, there might be some form of information that this has been dealt with by different politicians.
Es tut mir sehr leid, dass all der Aufwand, den das Auswärtige Amt da betrieben hat, all die Arbeitsstunden für umsonst waren. Aber So ist es mit der Demokratie. Hier ist übrigens auch noch unser EP-Präsident.
That's how it works with democracy.
Der Nachfolger von Schulz.
This is the president of the European Parliament, Tajani. And this is my boss, Martin Sonneborn.
Und Tajani, der ist
and
hier
Tajani,
nicht so bekannt wie Martin Schulz, aber
not that well known in Germany like the former president Martin Schulz. But he was the former press officer Silvio Berlusconi.
Haben nur die Besten bei uns.
And you know, we only have the best here in Brussels.
Ich erkläre die Unterschiede, also ich erkläre
so I want to talk a little bit about the differences between the European Parliament and the German Parliament.
Und zwar weil die meisten Leute den Bundestag
know
und den something about besser kennen als das Europaparlament.
Know the German Parliament much, much better. For example, they know this picture, but they don't know that picture. The one of Germany they know, and the one of Strasbourg they don't. What you can see behind there, that's a bunch of cabins for the live translation, live interpretation, just like the one over here in this room, just a lot more. And we translate everything into all of the official languages of the European Union in 23 languages.
This has the added benefit that
it doesn't happen that we, like in the German Parliament, sometimes meetings go until 4 a.m. in the morning. But here that doesn't happen because the translator just don't do it for forever. And they, if they go home, everyone goes home. So one of the biggest differences here is you can see it here in the picture. There's small computers over there. And here in the German Parliament, no, nothing on the computers.
Nothing on the tables.
Because we here in the European Parliament, we have an electronic system. This is from Julia Reda. There you can see the final vote on the copyright reform. In the European Parliament,
Frage,
the
last one we had there. Wieso gibt's im Bundestag sowas nicht? Sind die so rückständig neben dem Bundestag?
Think, well, weil da sind die Mehrheiten ja immer klar. Why don't we have that in, also
wenn die
in the
sagt, wir wollen
German
das,
Parliament? And after all, the decision, the thing is that there, the decisions are already pre-made. If there's no majority, nothing comes to a vote. But
in the, da gab's dann halt eine Abstimmung, die wirklich frei war. Und da muss man auch mal in der Regel im Bundestag
exceptions to this rule. So, for example, for same-sex marriage in the German Parliament, you also had a vote that was kind of free and no one knew what how the result would be. But in the European Parliament, that happens all of the time. We have a system of flexible majorities in the European Parliament. Some of the bigger groups work together somehow a little bit like the Grand Coalition in Germany.
Dass sich unterschiedliche
Allianzen in many questions there are different alliances that form
just in time.
For example, about budget issues, the leftists, they
asked
for, well, you know, the, all of the members of the European Parliament have a fixed amount of money they can spend on their local offices, and they don't have to really do any record keeping for how they spend this money. And the leftists made this proposal, well, why don't we do some guidelines that there has to be some records how this money is being spent? And suddenly there was a majority, also, for example, the conservatives with the British conservatives, they agreed as well. So the thing is, in the European Parliament, conservatives aren't conservatives. The German conservatives are very different from the British, for example. The Germans, they want to have some trust put in them, and like they don't want everything being checked. But the British Tories, they are very strictly in favor of transparency, and that's why they might as well work together with the leftists in some cases like this one.
Erinnert euch nach Heiko Maas?
Can you remember Heiko Maas? Now he's a foreign minister in Germany, and back in the days he was very strictly against data retention. And suddenly then he turned into the Minister of Justice of Germany, and then he was strongly in favor of data retention. So there are some things that make it more the case that in the European Parliament there are democratic decisions.
Minderheitsregierung, Kooperationskoalition.
Minority governments,
das könnte zum Beispiel dazu führen, dass die SPD in Abstimmung geht, sagen wir mal.
This might lead to the fact that the SPD might go on a sign to to circumcise picks. But now we have a collision portion, so the each coalition has to vote in unison. For instance, a few years ago there was a case. Now we go back to Axel Voss. Just have a look at it. It's similar to the German parliament. It's not proportional.
The
majorities are not represented proportionally, but we have the left, we have the SD, we have the Greens.
Eine grüne Fraktion. Und deutschen Grünen, da sind aber, ist auch zum Beispiel Julia Reda von den Piraten mit drin, Frau Buchner von der ÖDP, Liberale bei der letzten Europawahl, da war die Welt noch in Ordnung.
Na, last elections, everything was in order. Da Leute
entsendet die FDP in die Fraktion,
so
die Europäische Volkspartei, die Fraktion der Europäischen Volkspartei mit der deutschen CDU-CSU, was nicht mal alle wissen, die im Europaparlament sitzt die deutsche CDU mit der Widersprüche von Orban in einer Fraktion.
Ist in the same
wenn dann party like
the party of Orban. This is why he's always a visitor at the
CDU. Wir haben dann rechts davon gibt es die ECR. Das ist eine Fraktion, die aus der EVP ergeben, da sind die britischen Tories drin. Die sind so konservativ, aber
ganz gut. With the British Tories, they're like EPP, you're not very, you're friendly.
Dann wird's langsam irre.
Then it's getting a little bit crazy. It's the EFDD.
Die größte Delegation darin
ist the biggest delegation.
UKIP um Nigel Farage.
In this
hat einen gewissen Unterhaltungswert.
Group is the group of Nigel Farage. They're very successful at the moment.
Unabhängigkeit.
Independence of the UK.
Warten wir erstmal im März ab, vielleicht wird es ja doch noch also erfolgreich. Naja.
Well, let's wait for
auf jeden
March.
Fall,
maybe
da ist auch noch die Fünf-Sterne-Bewegung aus Italien mit drin.
Also
das wirkt ein bisschen komisch, ist es auch, weil die
it
politisch eigentlich gar nicht viel gemein
bizarre,
haben. Also das Abstimmungsverfahren. Die haben mir mal verraten, die wurden da so ein bisschen reingequetscht.
They,
in die
well, they told me they were
wollten
just
auch mehr voraus,
told
hat
into joining this group.
Da haben wir noch eine rechtsradikale Fraktion.
Then we also have a right radical group.
ENF. Hat sich ursprünglich gegründet aus Marine Le Pen,
by people like Marine Le Pen, Front National,
FPÖ, Partei für die Freiheit, Gerd Wilders,
Party of Gerd
Leute,
Wilders.
Das sind, die versammeln sich
Yo,
da.
Those people,
das ist leider eine Fraktion, die momentan in aktuellen Wahlprognosen relativ großes Wachstum vorausgesagt wird.
Like it's expected they grow
aber
a lot.
Es wird ja offenbar auch ein bisschen salonfähiger, was man hier nicht vergessen darf.
But
die politische
we shouldn't
Mitte
forget
hier,
that the
Mitte, und the die rechtsradikalen hier,
middle and the right radicals
können ja unproblematisch in Österreich eine Regierungskoalition bilden. Hier haben wir
might
noch die
make a government coalition in Austria.
Das ist hier besonders fies, das sind gar nicht so viele, das sieht hier nur so viel aus, weil
it looks like they're a big group, but this is the members without
das sind die Leute, die keiner haben will.
Those are the people that nobody wants.
So Nazis von der Goldenen Morgenröte aus Griechenland
Nazis
drin. Zwei griechische Kommunisten, die dürfen nicht nebeneinander sitzen.
Greek,
da gibt's eine körperliche Auseinandersetzung. Das ist kein Witz.
They're not allowed to sit next to each other. Not joking.
But Greek debates. There's some wir haben Udo Vogt von der NPD da.
Hungarian members of parliament.
Uns.
And there's us.
Das hat zur Folge, also ich kann das so sagen, wenn ich jetzt in Brüssel unterwegs bin und Leute kennenlerne, die nicht aus Deutschland kommen, sage ich so,
when I tell them I'm from Germany, they're like, oh yes, which group are you belong to?
Und,
and I say, no,
ja,
not in a group, and I say,
manchmal gehen die Leute auch weg. Naja.
Well, no, Nazis.
Hier, ich wollte es der Korrektheit halber ganz kurz hier noch
just
anzeigen.
Just to be complete, yeah, I wanted to show the real percentage of each group.
Haben wir gar nicht viele gerade, es sind 23,3%.
Well, without group, it's only 23%. It looked a little bigger than it actually
so,
is.
Ganz kurz,
the EU legislation procedure.
Gehen wir mal ganz kurz durch.
Let's have a short look at it. There are two important
Verordnungen und Richtlinien.
There are directives and there are guidelines.
Eine eurer Lieblingsverordnungen, von denen ihr quasi mit denen ihr kürzlich Verbindung wart.
Some of the directives that you
das Verordnung macht aus, dass sie über nationalem Recht stehen.
Directives
über nationalem Recht stehen. Und unmittelbar gelten und verbindlich sind.
So the first
in allen
group
Teilen.
Is the regulations, which is immediately placed into law.
So it,
once it is agreed by the co-legislators, it is the legal standard for all of the European Union. The other thing is the directives, which is are guidelines that the national parliaments then have to turn into national law. So as long as the national parliament hasn't taken it over yet, it is not legally binding. So first the commission comes up with a proposal, and then both the council and the parliament discuss it on their own, and then they come together, and if they both agree to the same version, then it is passed in the first reading, and if that doesn't happen, then it goes back to discussion, and then the second one, and so on and so forth. But practically, this doesn't really happen, because there is this custom system that has a system that is called informal trilogue. So we cut away the rest, and when the commission proposal comes into the parliament comes up with things that they want to change about this proposal, and then they go to the council, and they come together in this informal trilogue.
Und beraten dann darüber, wie sie das finden. Wenn sie dann zum Ergebnis kommen,
both,
ist das direkt schon vorbei.
Discuss what they want to put into this, and then it gets into first reading, and then it's over. That has some benefits. For example, it's fast. It is discussed, and moderated by the commission. But one of the downsides is that it isn't open to the public. So, like, you know when it happens, but you don't know what is happening behind those doors. There's no protocol or anything. Some things are being published nowadays because some people have sued ravenously
against
these institutions. And there is one thing called four-column documents. So, for example, this is from Julia Reda about the copyright reform. This is our favorite article, Article 13 about upload filters. And here in the first column, this is what the proposal of the commission looks like. Then in the second, what the parliament wants to have. The third one, what the council wants to have. And the fourth one is what they are currently compromising about. And someone has sued the institutions to make this public, the council was strongly against this, but finally now it is the case that when you ask for these documents to be published, they have to hand it out. And that is a very important victory for informational freedom.
Ich wollte jetzt das mal ganz kurz an einem Beispiel erklären.
Also, I want to use an example. For example, copyright. So Julia Reda, she was
in charge of the European Parliament report.
So we don't have the possibility to make a proposal, but we can make a report. To tell the commission, well, this is what we would like you to propose. And then the commission comes around with a proposal, and then it is moved into the committee that is talking about the specific issue in the European Parliament. So in this case, it is the Justice Affairs, Legal Affairs Committee. And then they come up with their opinion about that. And there's a bunch of important people there. There's the rapporteur, and then there's the shadow rapporteurs. Sometimes this is mentioned in debates or in the public this term. So if you want to look this up, you can go to the website of the European Parliament, and here you can see who are those people. And so in this case, the rapporteur is Axel Voss from the European People's Party, and then you see from all of the other groups who is responsible for this file. And the rapporteur tries to come up with some form of text version that comes up with a majority in negotiations with the shadow rapporteurs. All of these things are transparent in the European Parliament, so you can look that up on the website. It is a giant page with all sorts of things. You can see all of the reports from committees, you can see all of the changes being proposed. And then finally it comes to a vote vote in the committee. And with the majority in this committee, the committee can already decide that informally we start discussing this in the trilogue together with the council. So, for example, in this case, Article 13, Article 11, upload filters, and ancillary right for press publishers, both of these things are in this proposal, and the committee decided to start negotiations with the council about this.
And
then this whole thing moves to the vote in the in the plenary with all of the 751 members, and we try to figure out a majority to stop these negotiations, and we unfortunately didn't succeed. And here you can see all of the German members of the European Parliament, how they voted. So the CDU, all of them are in favor, of course, of upload filters and so on and so forth. With the Social Democrats here, it's a different picture. There's a bunch of people who have voted in favor of this as well. But, for example, one of the people who are strongly against upload filters is, for example, Timo Werken. Maybe some of you know him. He found a couple of votes with the Social Democrats who are against this. With the Greens, there it was 50-50. Julia Reda from the Pirates is also in that group, and she found a couple of people to against this, but also one person who is very strictly in favor of upload filters. Helga Trippel is curiously also a Green, and therefore this was like 50-50.
Hat, glaube ich, 62, die dagegen gestimmt haben, 45. Vielleicht auch ein bisschen eine Generationenfrage.
Maybe it's a matter of generation, because all of the older people within the Greens have voted in favor of this, and all of the younger people have voted against.
Wenn irgendwelche SPD-Leute anfangen, ihre eigene Gruppe aufzumachen, dann nee.
In Germany, this would be unthinkable for the Social Democrats to start finding a couple of people to vote against things, but here this is normal. So unfortunately, this has passed. Some of you might remember this picture. This is Axel Voss, the rapporteur. He's very happy. I'm going to start calling him now Mr. Upload Filter. And
yeah,
that's a really bad picture.
Dann war die Sache, hat er quasi, da hat er das Mandat bekommen. Und
but yeah, he got the mandate to start negotiations with the
die Schattenberichterstatterin für die
Grünen,
Julia Reda.
And this is what's currently going on. So Julia Reda, she's the shadow rapporteur for the Green Group, tries to get some transparency into all of these discussions and publishes some files.
So
the thing is, once the trilogue is over, the whole file comes back into the European Parliament, because the plenary still has to accept this, and so there it will be important to find a majority against this. There were multiple millions of signatures on the petition to safeguard the internet that we know, and this is being endangered by upload filters. Upload filters are being put in place would mean that all of the content that is being uploaded onto platforms has to be scanned beforehand by some kind of filter. And for the moment, this is being discussed, as I said before, in this trilogue. And I would really, really hope that the Net community would find a way to rally a lot of people against this, because this is a really, really tough fight, and it's also a dirty fight.
Der Kampf wird schmutzig geführt von alle Seiten mit harten Bandagen, aber wir haben es da wirklich mit den Befürwortern auch, sagen wir mal,
it is really, really hard, because the people in favor of this
are really far removed from facts.
There are people that say, well, there won't be any upload filters, and that's simply not a basis for discussion, because that's not true. So what I want to give you on the way for the elections, take a look at this. Don't listen too much to what they are telling you, what they're going to do in the future, but rather look at what they did in the past. For example, here.
verfolgt die Medien, lasst euch nicht von
think about it, read, take care of the news, take in the news, it's going to be very interesting how this is going to run down. Think about that there will not be a blocking 3% block for the election, so you might as well also work for smaller parties. I want to do some advertisement for the democratic ways of the European Parliament is that it is really easy for, or comparatively easy for small parties in the European Parliament to take part in the big discussions, because it is, they can lead discussions there. I would hope that this would also happen in Germany, for example. Just think about it, where we would have a government where a smaller partner in this government would be able to do those things that it wants to be known for politically, and doesn't simply have to agree to compromises. What I really like about the democratic structure in the European Parliament is that there is this negotiation between the Parliament and the Council, and you've seen before it's really, really hard for the Council to find these majorities, 65% and so on and so forth.
And it's
a really tough weight of the elected chamber of the European Parliament, and which has to play an important role against the Council
dann doch nicht kommen, weil die Mitgliedstaaten es blockieren.
And oftentimes it happens that some things are being blocked by the member states there. I don't want to make you any hope, because unfortunately currently it seems like there is no strong movement in favor of like European integration. But yeah, maybe vote on the right place next year in May. It might just be a small step, but thank you anyways.